Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to see how Zenor diode acts as a voltage regulator. The last video we have seen what is Zenor diode and what is the basic principle or effect that is seen in Zenor diode. That is Avalanche effect and Zenor effect. In this one, we are going to see due to these two effects. Zenor diode has one important property, that one we are going to see here. The basic important quality, it is always keep a constant voltage across a load. How it is happen? That one we are going to see. To understand this one, consider a water tank. Imagine the case, this water tank may contain 100 liter. It can store, that is, this water tank can store 100 liter. Okay, then there is one pipe here. This pipe, through this pipe, it can pass near to 30 liter per second. 30 liter per second. Okay. Then imagine the case, this water tank is going to fill. Initially, it is filled with 5 liter or 10 liter. It is filled with 10 liter of water. This is 10 liter of water. This much area is filled. And then, this imagine the case pipe is open. The same water will flow through here. That is 5 liter per second. That water will flow. 5 liter. Per second, that water will flow. Then imagine it increases to 10 liter or 20 liter. This increases to 20 liter. This is 20 liter. Then you can see those entire 20 liter water will flow through this pipe. 20. Then this increases to 30 liter. This is the top of this pipe. Then those 30 liter will start to flow through this one. Imagine this become 50 liter. Then what will be the current situation? How much amount of water, quantity of water that will flow through this pipe? It is only 30 liter because pipe has the capacity to carry 30 liter through this one. So only 30 liter of water will flow through this pipe. So whether it is 40 liter, 50 liter, 60 liter, 70 liter, 80 liter, 90 liter or 100 liter, pipe always give constant 30 liter per second. If it goes below 30 liter, the capacity of or the water stored in the water tank is below 30 liter per 30 liter, then only pipe will reduce the quantity of water. If it is above this 30 liter, it is always constant. Imagine if it is 1000 liter tank and the stiffness of pipe is if it is not that much good, then there will be upper boundary. That is, it is going beyond a particular amount of water in this tank that will exert some pressure on the walls of this pipe. There is a chance of breakage, broken of this pipe. So there will be upper limit. But whatever it is, the lower limit always 30 liter. If we want to get always 30 liter per second, in the tank there should be minimum 30 liter per second. If it is below 30 liter, we will get less amount of water. If it is above 30 liter, we will always get 30 liter per second. The same working principle is the case of Zener diode. That one you can easily understand the graph of Zener diode. See. See, graph of Zener diode. This is the reverse wave. We are not focusing on the forward bias of Zener diode. In forward bias, Zener diode will act as a normal diode. See the case of reverse bias. In reverse bias, up to VZ, Zener diode is normal diode. It will not permit any current to pass through this one, through the device, that is through Zener diode. But after VZ, that is breakdown voltage, the ideally the Zener voltage, that breakdown voltage is constant and we are getting infinite current. This is ideal situation, but this is not the real situation. In real situation, you can see there will be practically the VI curve of Zener diode is like this. That is, up to this point, the current is very small. Zener diode will not permit flow large amount of current. But after this point, that is Zener breakdown, for small increase in voltage, we are getting large increase of current. That is, ideally we can say voltage is constant and current is infinity. But that is the ideal situation. Practically you can say for small change in voltage, current is increasing very large. So take the case here. This is the forward bias. In forward bias, Zener diode is acting as a short circuit, or you may study the piecewise linearity or constant voltage drop linearity like that. So in forward bias, it is acting as a short switch. We can represent if it is a diode. In forward bias, normal diode, we are representing as a small closed switch. So this diode, you can either represent as a closed switch like this, or you can represent as in constant voltage drop model, or you can represent as piecewise linearity, that is a small resistance and a constant voltage drop. This is the three cases of representing a diode in forward bias. The same thing is applicable here. But you take here this region. In this region, for large change of voltage, small change of current. That is, if you are taking resistance R equal to V by I, or delta V divided by I, delta I, where this delta I is almost zero, you can say almost zero, or it is very small value. The change in current here, this is the current axis, change in current is almost zero, it is constant here, but voltage change is very large. So ideally here resistance is very very high, or you can say it is infinity or open circuit in reverse bias. So in this region, Zener diode acting as an open circuit up to this region. Up to this region, Zener diode acting as open circuit. But from here to here, you can see for small change in voltage, large current means resistance. Here you can say small change in voltage. That is a small value on the numerator, but very large value on the denominator. That is voltage and this is current. Small value on the numerator, large value on the denominator. means this will be very very small, this value will be very very small. So in the reverse bias, after breakdown voltage, Zener diode is representation is small value of resistance or with a constant voltage. This is the representation. In ideal case, this small resistance also will be zero, because if this change in voltage is zero, means if its graph is like this, somewhat like this, if the graph is constant like this, if the graph is like this, that is for zero voltage, change in zero voltage, change in voltage is zero, we are getting infinite current. Then we can represent that Zener diode in reverse bias with a battery or a voltage source with value VZ. If it is practical case, we can add one resistor also due to change in voltage. That value will be delta V by delta I. This is the actual working principle of Zener diode. And this application we are using in the case of voltage regulator. See, whatever the value of input supply, or whatever the increased in current, that is, if we are increasing input supply, automatically current will increase. But Zener diode in reverse bias, if this VPS is greater than VZ, that is breakdown voltage, if it is greater than this breakdown voltage, and then diode, Zener diode in this region, that is in this operation region. So make sure that Zener diode always in this reverse bias breakdown region, then only it will act as a voltage regulator. So that is very very important. Not all Zener diode that is in reverse bias will not act as a voltage regulator. If a Zener diode want to operate as a voltage regulator, it should be in breakdown region, it should be in this region, then only it will act as a voltage regulator. Means the supplied voltage always greater than VZ. So if this VPS is greater than VZ, and if we are increasing the voltage, current will increase. Then even though that current is increasing, VZ will be constant. This VZ will be constant, that we were seeing here. VZ is constant even though increasing the current. So whatever the input voltage, we are getting a constant voltage at output. Same way, after in the filtering, we are getting a voltage. Imagine this is 10 volt. 10 volt. The upper point of this one is 10 volt and lower point of this one is 8 volt. I require a constant voltage like this. If I am choosing this is 7 volt and this is VZ, that is Zener value. Then if I am giving this voltage as a VPS, so its upper value is 10 volt and lower value is 8 volt. Zener will give only 7 volt, constant 7 volt. Only constant 7 volt. So I am getting a constant DC as output. So this is the one easiest method we are getting a constant voltage in output. Regulator supply in output. Then it can be two methods. One is line regulation, second one is load regulation. That one we can see in the next video. By that we can conclude the regulator, voltage regulator, regulator DC power supply. Thank you.